Students, welcome to the Wame Academy. My name is Mr. Boyle and I am the Secondary Assistant Principal. We are very happy to have you at Wame. We're excited to make this video and introduce you to our school and give you some advice about how to smoothly transition from the Chinese system to the American system. Your first few days at Wame will be filled with many, many changes. Here are just a few differences you can expect to see. One of the first major differences you will see between the American system and the Chinese system is that in the American system, we really want you to participate in class. In Chinese school, you may be used to your teacher giving you all of the information and expecting you to memorize it, and you'll find that that's very different here. Your American and Western teachers will expect you to be able to not just answer questions, but also to ask questions, formulate an opinion, respond to other people's opinions, and give feedback to other students. Making sure you are comfortable and capable speaking in class rather than being quiet and listening will be one of the first major adjustments you'll have to make at our school. In the American system, we care about more than just your grades and test scores. In the Chinese system, you're used to taking very big, very important tests and exams. Here, your exams, your SAT scores, your TOEFL scores are also important, but the American education system values a holistic approach to education, which means we care more about you than just simply your grades. We want to see you participate in a variety of activities, take on leadership, and find things that you're really passionate about and interested in. So some advice to you would be to join the volleyball team, basketball team, or soccer team. Have a goal to be a part of student government. Participate in a service trip or an adventure trip, or lead an ASA. Or, a great example is the students who are putting this video together. Find something that you're interested in and pursue it. American universities are looking for students who have a wide variety of interests and experiences, not just students who are good test takers.
Hi kids, my name is Mr. Fowler. I'm a science teacher at your school here, DIS, Huamei Academy. I want to encourage you that when you are here in class and in the hallways, eating lunch, or even if you live in the dorms, to speak English as much as you can. The more that you practice speaking English, the more that you practice learning English, the better you'll be at it, and the better you'll be prepared for going to a university in the United States or Canada or somewhere else in Europe.
Hi everyone, I'm Mr. Carter, and I'm here to talk about plagiarism. Plagiarism is defined as the taking of anyone's words or ideas and presenting them as your own. Plagiarism is a large academic problem. It can be something as simple as accidental plagiarism, where you didn't properly cite a source, or it can be deliberate plagiarism, where you copy someone's paper and turn it as your own. Here at DAIS, we work diligently to make sure each and every student knows and understands what plagiarism is and how to avoid it. Unfortunately, though, if you are someone that is repeatedly plagiarizing, you could ultimately jeopardize your potential admission to the university and other opportunities in your future.
My name is Miss Laney. Laney is my family name. And so I am the college counselor for Huamei. It means I take care of all of the Chinese students. I help with finding a college and applying to college, but I also help with scheduling and report cards and grades.
I'd like to show you two things about Power School. This
is your daily schedule. And so if you go on PowerSchool with your phone, you can see what you have Monday for A block, B block, where you have advisory, lunch, my favorite part, then third block, and then fourth block. Tuesday, you can see what class you have every day of the week. And then on the weekend, you'll know what happens next week, how you need to plan on Monday. That's one of the things that you need to be ready for. The other thing is, I want you to see here is your grades. So you can see each class and what grade you're getting now. And you can look, you can see if you're missing an assignment, you can see if you haven't turned in all your work, or you can see if your grade is low and if you need to ask your teacher for a reassessment. Both of these things are part of PowerSchool. Down at the bottom is your GPA, your grade point average. This number right here, it tells me how good of a student you are. And when you apply to an American or a Canadian or a British university, the first thing they look at is this number. And this number is the result of all of these grades. So it shows me right here how good a student you are. All right, come ask me if you have a question. Welcome to DAIS.
Hi, I'm Mrs. Mihawk, and I'm the GST supervisor. Welcome to GST. GST stands for Guided Study Time, and this is the time when we provide teacher support to help our students study, not only to complete their homework, to study for tests, but also to improve their English skills. We provide teacher and RC support every night, Monday through Thursday, from 6 p.m. to 8 p.m. Students can use the school computers to finish projects, to print, or to work together on group projects, as these students are preparing for their English final. We really hope that we can be a help to you in earning good grades, learning good study habits, completing your homework, and developing English skills.
So, I'd like to welcome you, first of all, to the PE facilities that we have here. And right now, right here, this is your soccer pitch. You'll have many a soccer game or PE class out here. And during your ASA, which is your after-school activities, and then after guided GST, which is guided study time, you'll be allowed to use this facility. So, now we're in the gym. And in the gym, we have basketball, and we have volleyball, which you'll be able to turn out for volleyball team in the fall. You'll be able to turn out for the basketball team. And if you make the Akamas teams on either volleyball or basketball, you'll be able to go to Macau, to Beijing, to play in a tournament, which is really cool. This is our weight room. Now, this is where some of your PE classes, your individual sport classes, will participate. We have dumbbells, easy curl, all the benches we basically need. We have a bench press, squat rack, and your PE teachers will show you how to use all of these, okay? We also, if you look over there a little bit further, we have aerobic activity machines, and then we have other weightlifting machines right over here. Alright, so now this is our swimming pool. We have a 5-way pool, and we will go swimming classes in here and water aerobics classes. And if you are in part of my class, we're going to do something new next year, synchronized swimming. And then one other thing, if it all works out, I'm really hoping it does, we're going to combine with the physics class and make boats and maybe have some boat races in the water. So if you're part of the physics class or my PE class, that is a strong possibility. Alrighty? So I hope you've enjoyed our small tour of facilities. If you have more questions when you get here in the fall, Remember, my name is Mr. Seibelts. Please come up and ask me, and I will be glad to talk to you and introduce you to our school.
This is our circulation desk. When you find a book you want to check out, you come up here to the circulation desk to check it out. What do you need to check out a book? You need your school ID card. Here comes someone now.
Whoa. Hi, Miss Lush.
Here's his school ID card. You want to check out all these books?
Yeah.
Here's a bit of bad news. You can only check out 5 books at a time.
Oh my God.
You'll have to find the 5 you want.
Okay.
Okay. I'm going to use his school ID card and check out the books in the system for him by scanning each book. He can keep these books for 2 weeks. After 2 weeks, he needs to return the books by placing them in our Dropbox.